Well,
why stop there?
The first band, come on! It's gonna be Nyx Assassin as well as the Lone Druid the Bear.
Yep, Liquid goes on the dire side for this game. As indeed mentioned, it is a best of five, so it's all about adjusting to the other team and to be the one to adjust best and fast. Because you do have three games potentially. Magnus gets removed.
That makes me sad. I love seeing Magnus, and I love seeing FY play it.
Oh, come on, you
and
can't
Liquid,
let him have
Liquid
it.
Are denying us.
Or
that.
RTK Magnus. I wasn't disappointed when we saw that earlier in that tournament.
I mean,
tournament.
Both of them.
Yeah.
Is it going to be a wisp ban?
We should hope so. I mean, if
they,
there's
they
one
might
thing...
not.
I think they might leave it in.
They might leave it in and go for Bounty Hunter again. Maybe even Timbersaw on their side early on.
They might just ban the Slaughter again.
Yeah, but if you ban Slaughter, you give away a wisp.
Many have made that mistake against Liquid. You play against Liquid, you don't ban wisp, you think you can counter it. And
I
then
think
he
you
lose.
Ban Wisp and give them Slardar personally.
This is the game to try it out, though. If you do think you can beat the IO, a game two where you're one game up, Liquid, that's the game to let it through. You shouldn't let it through if you're behind. They don't let it through. They do ban it out.
Yep.
So Slardar is still in the pool. We've seen openings of Warlock Centaur, of course. Keeper of the Light is still in the pool. There are so many good heroes still left in.
Slaughter,
it's all about Slaughter is of course number one as well.
Maybe
but
Keeper,
Centaur.
Centaur. Oh, okay. Yeah. Centaur is way different.
Worked out well for RTK.
Yeah.
If we want to have a bit of a slice of that pie.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm interested in how a Centaur warrants a first pick there, Ben. You really think that was worth it?
Well, what do you give up in return? You can give up Slaughter Lifestealer, but Centaur has been that strong team fighting ultimate, and you can get that. The Ags, which all the Centaurs seem to get Ags like a really good timing. I'm not really sure how that happens every single game, but they get it at like 25-30, and then none of your cores need to get BKBs until like very, very late. It's that team, that Ags is one of the best Ags in the game if you can get it at the timing that they do.
Previous game, RTK obviously had the Bounty Hunter helping him out with that little bit of extra track gold, and there were a lot of skirmishes, so there was a lot of track gold involved. But let's see what VGJ is going for here. Is there any combination that you don't want to give away for the Centaur? Because we have seen a lot of Centaur Warlock pickups together.
Yeah.
Do you want to take the Warlock away from them?
I think Lifestealer is actually pretty good versus them. So Slaughter Lifestealer is kind of one of the ones that you want to go for. Slaughter Keeper.
Yeah, I think they got plenty of time to lock in the Lifestealer. I mean, I'd much rather grab that Keeper early.
I like this. They have to pick, if they want to play it, they have to pick it up there.
Yep.
Otherwise, it will get banned out, and they're going to need to bring their A-game Liquid. I mean, letting VGJ open with Slaughter and the FY Keeper of the Light, it's risky. I mean, this boy on the old man and his horse.
Yeah, they need to ban a couple of heroes, though. You can't give them Keeper and Storm, and you... Keeper and Storm is really, really good. We saw it, actually, I think, in the prior series, too.
Yes, we did.
Liquid. The question is, with the Invoker picked up, do you ban out the Brew? Or was that just last game a testament to you can deal with it?
I mean, I think that we saw that Brew in the last game. It was good, it was impressive, but it wasn't what they needed, and it wasn't enough. And they know what they're going to be looking for if they pick that up again. So I would be surprised, Sheever, but you never know. You could be looking at the next level strat, Sheeves.
The amp you can actually use to kill the Earth Panda, too. So even if you do give it away, it's like not... I personally wouldn't ban it out here. At least you know it's coming. If they do pick it, you just need to make sure that you draft strong enough team fight. So they ban out two of the good keeper partners, Naga and Storm.
And yeah, and there's the Lifestealer.
They managed to get it in the second phase, which is...
This feels like so strong for VGJ. I mean, these three heroes... it feels like the three heroes that they would have wanted to have, you know, regardless of what's been banned out. I think the Storm ban, as you mentioned, Ben, that Liquid should have done and they have done is very good, as that would have been perfect in what VGJ have so far.
I wonder what other tricks they have up their sleeve, though. I think VG has shown that they have more interesting things in store than any other team in this tournament.
Absolutely.
Bounty Hunter, we haven't seen at all. It's been banned sometimes. You know, the Naga Siren, the only win here with Naga at this tournament. Storm Spirit was kind of just off the radar. Everyone thought that the hero sucked because of the changes to Root, but they've used him also quite successfully. So, how deep is their pool?
Yeah.
FY on the safe lane Magnus? What? Like, what?
All right, well, this next pick coming out from Liquid should tell us a lot. I mean, pretty easy to guess that they're going to grab that Invoker for Miracle God, but where else are we going to be going with this draft? Anyone's particularly...
You said Warlock is safe. Warlock is definitely a safe pick, but...
Yeah.
What about just going for an SD Luna game?
Come on. Please.
I mean, you're down a game. You say, screw it, we'll play SD Luna.
We saw SD Luna once this tournament.
Yes, you can read how SD Luna did on DC's gravestone.
Yes.
I think Lifestealer is really...
I don't think she was very happy with that.
What are you talking about? She's laughing. She's covering. She was happy.
Uh-huh.
She was just embarrassed.
Yeah. Embarrassed. Just an embarrassed lady. Anywho.
I don't like SD Luna.
No, no one likes. And there's the Warlock. All right. So,
Warlock is by far the safest pick.
Absolutely.
Just go for mass team fight. They don't have the Stampede to counter it. And you have some form of anti-BKB against the Lifestealer. That was really big last game that none of their cores could deal with BKB.
It was such a long cooldown.
Owen, you were the one who said it didn't work.
Don't you feel they're going to need something else to go through Magic Mystery?
I actually like the Axe a lot versus the Lifestealer Slaughter, but Axe kind of takes the same position as Centaur.
Yeah, we're really fitting, would it?
So there's not that many anti-BKB supports that you can pick nowadays. SD is like okay, but he's very mediocre.
Yeah, Team Liquid does like to pick people up with kind of long stuns to pair up with their Invoker, so you're going to need somebody.
Well, we still have a support hero left to be picked up, so there's still plenty of time to pick up that core that does it. And hey, who knows? Maybe they want to go back for the Sven. That's a stun right there.
No.
Not the Sven.
Please don't bring out the Sven again.
They picked it. They obviously thought it could work.
Yeah, it's okay. It's just it's just Sven, though. You get kited.
Yes, and we saw that, exactly.
Yeah, it's just a little rough.
Yeah.
There's very few situations that I would actually like to, like, be a Sven in, as the carry. Maybe if you're versus a Meepo, some other specific situations, but in general, yeah.
All right, so who do we want to see here for VGJ?
So we're not sure where the Slaughter is. We haven't seen ROTK play it, so I'm almost positive it's actually going to be FY.
We normally see FY play it. But they are keeping it open by picking up that Ember Spirit right now.
I like having the Root. The Root is really good for Centaur, and the counter initiation with Stampede. Stampede is really good at like resetting a team fight so you can reposition yourself.
They are picking it into an Invoker though, so you know Liquid have a bit of a way of getting rid of that Flame Guard.
I haven't seen Miracle play too much Quas Web.
No, for sure. Yeah, that is not his optimal build.
But I don't actually think that counter is that bad, actually. The Ember Spirits, like, before it's like, oh my god, I can't use Flame Guard, but now you just wait until the tornado to use Flame Guard and then you go in again, so it's not as bad. Also, a lot of them have picked up the one slight early to dodge the EMP in lane, so it's pretty good, actually, I think, for Invoker. Not amazing, but playable. Juggernaut. Magic Immunity. One of the better cores versus Lifestealer Slaughter. You want a core that can like survive on its own. Luna, you just die every time a Slaughter Lifestealer Jug. You have a decent shot of escaping. You Manta, you spin away.
Sure.
Whatever, you're good.
Diffuser Blade Karas or something else that can kind of deal with the Ember if you want to build it that way.
And also, you can actually siege buildings versus a Keeper. That is super important. Last game we saw it. Lifestealer, Rage, bam, hit towers, you're good for 6 seconds. Juggernaut, same thing. You spin, you hit towers, you're good. Like, you don't need to pop a BKB or a Manta or have a Lotus on you or MKB. Oh, actually, you can't MKB and hit buildings, but, like, you don't need any of these things. You have an innate skill that deals with Keeper's high ground defense.
All right. Let's see here. Now, who are we looking for? Who's our missing puzzle piece there, Sheeves?
The missing piece of the puzzle. And you're asking the host.
I'm saying the player. What player are we looking for?
Which side?
Jarax for
sides?
Liquid.
Yeah.
Jarax for Liquid.
That's Jarax for Liquid. We just want to see the push band out.
Yeah, yeah. I'm just trying to cycle through here the ROTK.
Earth Spirit is, I think, really good for Liquid.
Yeah,
I'm
a little surprised that's still available because that could be good for
Disruptor. Jarax. I also think it's like okay, but I think I prefer Earth Spirit. But Earth Spirit. I like the instant disables versus the Lifestealer Ember, or else you're never going to be able to kill them. How are they going to stop them from actually popping Slight, popping Remnant, popping Rage? There's nothing right now except for the last pick that needs some sort of instant cast, I believe. Sand King sometimes used. Lion's okay, but not very popular nowadays.
For VGJ, ROT Axe could be very good for them, because then they would have that disable themselves through Jug's
like
Magic Immunity.
Oh, hey, guys.
What's up?
Underlord?
Yeah, Underworld is decent too.
There we go. That's the stun we're looking for.
Liquid doing it again.
Oh, yeah.
That is a great pick.
Dude,
that is tough. I mean, Enigma is good. Like, VGJ's teamfight is pretty terrible.
Yeah.
their AoE stun is Slardar, and they have no, like, bam. They have Warlock ult and Enigma ult. Both Pierce BKB.
Dude, so good. The team fight is incredible. Really, and if you missed game series one, the Enigma pick by Kuro, he was unbelievable by being able to catch
incredible.
That Ember. He
was top of the net worth at the end of the game. Darkseer, that will be it.
Well, that's kind of some anti-team fight right there, you know?
Darkseer's fast. Yeah. Like, you can fight in between the Infernal and the Black Hole cooldowns, but I'm still very worried about, like, them just getting crushed by the Enigma.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, so you're thinking that this is going to be a 1-1.
I like Liquid's lineup more.
What about you, Odipixel?
Yeah, I've got to agree. I want to see Liquid pick up something else that's going to deal through the Magic community and they get themselves the Enigma. I think it's a really, really good finisher.
Is it going to be unanimous here?
I'm going to have to say so. I mean, they played so well. I know I'm making a dumb decision, but I can't go against that Kuro Enigma. It was so good, and it'll be good again.
I can't really hear you over the crowd. That is definitely siding with VGJ here.
I believe so.
But you guys at home, are you ready for the second game? I'm sure you are, so sit back. Relax and let the lovely voices of Lyrical and Gods fill your ears. Seconds
remaining. Thank you very much, Shiver and the panel, and welcome back, everybody. Game 2 is online now. It is VGJ facing off against Liquid. We're going to hop right into it. Gods, do you like the Enigma pick? It's a hell of a lot of hate to throw out there on top of somebody's head.
It is. Kuro played a very good Enigma. He'll be picking up again. This seems like one of the few heroes where Kuro will kind of swap over to that full position role, take up a lot more farm. He likes the direction he can take with the game, I guess, when he's playing the Enigma. Sit in the jungle and just see what's going on. Try and time their movement. It kind of reminds me of when he used to take away some of those carries from Matu when he'd play, like, the Drow. I think he just feels, like, in control when he's on the hero that's, like, kind of the tempo control. You get your mech, you're ready to push. You get your level 6, you're ready to smoke kick. Like, he can dictate the flow of the game through this hero and does feel like a very good pick against the Lifestealer. Not a whole lot that can cancel it easily. There are disables, yes, but there's very close range disables with the Slaughter Crush, the Searing Chains, Vacuum, maybe one of the better ones, but also one of the ones you're going to be looking to use at the start of the fight. So we'll see how it does. For VG Gaming, though, ROTK Darkseer, this is historically one of his best heroes and a very strong combo with the FY Slaughter.
Yeah. Oh, and you know, you talked about being able to pick up that quick mechanism. I mean, if the game goes well enough, we saw him go for the Midas into, what was it, Blink Dagger and Octarine Core as third item. Not often that you see that.
That seemed a bit clowny. I don't know if you'd do that in the close game, but you've got 4 active spells, reduce all those cooldowns. Why the hell not? Tank up a lot. So we'll see. We'll be the Fenrir Coddle. This is one of the teams that does play that kind of. Last time they did this, it was with the Sand King Coddle. It wasn't the best. But we'll see if they can get away with, like, the greedy 5-position Coddle this time around.
It does look like we have a bit of a pause. I'm sure it'll just be a second or two as we're getting close to start this game off. But, you know, another thing to talk about a little bit is that this VG Gaming lineup last time around, they were just able to continuously siege high ground with the Rage Lifestealer. It's still something that you can sort of do a little bit. Like, if you drop the Golem or the Black Hole and it ends up getting canceled, then you're kind of in a worse spot than when you started.
Yeah. And they've got Omni Slash as well, so they've got good ways to deal with him in the Rage, and you also got to get in a position where you're sieging high ground too, so I think the bigger focus is still going to be on, like, the early mid-game stage, and it's a nice thing to have to fall back on. I mean, Ben mentioned the same thing with the Juggernaut. You can actually siege versus Illuminate, so I think both teams have ways to high ground siege if they get to that point. So any team that does well in the early to mid-game can end the game in timely fashion with an Aegis.
Looks like there they are going to be able to deny out one of the creeps from the mid lane. Miracle not going to have a range creep this time around. It looks like he's also going to have a little bit of help from his buddy, Mr. GH the Warlock. Taking Shadow Word at this early level means that an already tough matchup is going to become even tougher against this Invoker.
Dry lane mid, guys. Kind of what this is. Losing a range creep, having a Warlock there. He's like, what else can you throw at me, guys? FY, please come and help. Looks like FY may focus more on the harass. He finds Kuro in the jungle. He's likely going to try and snipe some of these Eidolons if possible. They do give good money as well as good XP. And also just block perhaps the respawn of this medium camp.
It's, I think, something that's kind of okay. You look at the way that they've kind of developed their game plan throughout this tournament, and sometimes they've been willing to sacrifice freeze and allow them to catch back up later on through team fights. So that's something that we could potentially look for. But yeah, as you mentioned, we can see now FY in the jungle, going to soak up that experience. And I mean, is he really going to be able to contest the farm of the Enigma?
No, not contested. He wants to cancel clarities, which there's still two more of. He should be able to get close enough for this one. There we go. Cancels one clarity. We'll take a bit of damage. Has got boots, though, so he can maneuver around. He wants to also farm these islands. There we go. 26 gold. Can't kill any more because they split, but tiny chunk of gold. He's just being disruptive. He knows he's not going to be able to stop the Enigma farm, but he can at least slow down the farm and slow down the level progression by sharing that experience. So he's being annoying more than anything else. He's going to get a couple more Eidolons. This is actually good farm. He kills off, well, I think that's three total or four total. So decent start for the FY Slada.
Oh, in the meantime, down bottom, Matumba Man has already used his spin and going to get chased down a little bit here by Aggressive. He's going to be forced back out of lane, at least for the moment. This is kind of a scary lane here with the Lifestealer Coddle.
Yeah, and Aggressive picks up boots. Sunstrike.
Oh, miracle.
This is wrong and not...
How is this?
Loses his salve. He runs in aggressively with the salve, which is interesting. Miracle turns around, gets the easy cancel, but looks like both players have their shrine available. But I say that Miracle needs to be careful going for his shrine. FY is waiting on the high ground. Whether he can get to that shrine or not will be the big question. Well, once he heals up a bit more, he should be fine though. Yeah, he's got enough HP now.
I mean, that's sort of the nice part about it for the Invoker is you have that point up in Quas, can get the heals up as well. It does look like they're going to rotate in with the haste rune and healing up Miracle. Make sure that he's going to be all fine and dandy, and I'll give a little couple pot shots to Freeze on his way through the lane.
A role reversal. Game one, it was Liquid winning most of the lanes, having a very good start. This time around, it's Vici Gaming with CS across all three of their cores. Top CS on the Dark Seer, the Lifestealer not far behind. Ember doing well enough against an Invoker, which isn't a very favorable matchup for the Ember. So, does feel like things in the lane stage at least looking good for Vici Gaming. And Kuro's Enigma just being disrupted by the Slada. That will not continue though. He's tucked himself away in a safer jungle position, and Slada's not really on top of him anymore.
GH is also going to be forced out and is going to need to TP back home, yeah, or at least over to the shrine.
Perhaps calling Kuro over to use that one. Maybe, it looks like Matu's late fearing down a wave is going to come in. So a three-man shrine.
Oh, Miracle turns to fight, wants to take this one. They get the kill, is going to end up fairy firing, trying to stay alive. Also had wand charges. No, that was the Invoker had wand charges. So they do take down the Ember in the end. That was really close to being great for Miracle, but ends up dying.
Early slide of fist. What a player. He thought he was perhaps dodging the Sunstrike. He timed it exactly right, but he gets the kill anyway. So does end up being a win for the Ember. Freeze this young player. Solo kill on Miracle. If there's a player with a solo kill in your competitive tournament debut, Miracle is definitely up there.
Uh-oh.
He's getting just in Miracle's face. Talked about this 1v1 matchup. If Ember can get in the Invoker's face with the Flame Guard, it does become a much tougher matchup for the Invoker.
And now a DD rune as well. I mean, a little bit of good luck going his way, as well as some very evident skill. It does look like Matumba Man again going to be forced to use the spin in this bottom lane, and all of these lanes really not going into the favor of Team Liquid at all. The Warlock is going to be forced back. Can they find the kill? Fairy Fire trying to stay alive, but he is going to die. And, well, maybe they can find something of it. They're able to take down Fenrir.
That's why he's got no mana for the TP. He's trying to clarity up. Gonna be close. Matu's hunting. Doesn't look like he'll find him in time. Or will he?
Oh, no! He turns back the other direction and, well, Matumba Man heard something maybe from the crowd and realized, hey, can I go back and check it out? But he was already gone. Well, nonetheless, Freeze in the mid lane. Gonna get Sunstrike, anticipating the dodge, but was not able to find him.
Yeah, looks like Miracle has stabilized things a bit here. He's still fairly healthy. This raindrop is a key item to have early on against the Ember Spirit, able to block the Searing Chains damage. Will make this mid lane a little bit tougher for the Ember Spirit to go too aggressive on. But he's got friends coming. He's got a two-man smoke gang ready to try and find another kill on the Invoker. Sentries are there too, so no Ghostwalk escape likely to be possible.
All right, well, and Miracle again is going to get wrapped on. They've got several heroes here. Chains connects. They also are going to be able to get the crush. He's pretty quick right now.
Yeah, and nice stampede save.
We'll survive. Sunstrike. FY. Ooh, just barely off the mark.
He saw it coming, it looks like. He sidestepped that one. Triple remnant mid.
Wants to find him. They get this chains. It's going to be able to do a good bit of damage.
Oh, the Illuminate misses.
Right there, though. The Malefist to turn. Freeze. Maybe in some trouble is going to fall. So gets a little bit aggressive and is punished.
Ooh, not sure if he slightly missed the Fire Remnant damage or possibly it's just the raindrop negating some of it. It did look like the damage was slightly out of range when he remnanted it in, but We'll have to watch the tape on that one. Either way, a great juke coming out from Miracle. Raindrops paying off for this Liquid mid laner. And the aggression from Freeze, this time getting punished. You know, you kind of get a bit kind of keen and eager to go for those kills. You're like, I already solo kill him once. You can kind of feel that things are going your way. Your team's probably kind of pumping you up as well, and you go for another, and this time around, Miracle gets the best of you. He's very good at doing, but ROTK crushing the top lane, level 8.5 to the level, about to be level 7 Centaur, and with complete utter free farm on Darks here, not to mention probably a decent chunk of jungle creeps in there as well, making full use of the Darks here.
I mean, top of the net worth, and this is with FI hanging out here as well. They are thinking for the moment about going on to mind control.
Stampede about to come back up though. Oh, vacuum into crush top.
Trying to go forward, gonna be able to connect. They got the iron shell on top of him, slowed up for the moment. Is he gonna be able to get that stampede off? They need to find him, and it looks like with the chase, with the crush, they'll get the kill. VGJ is making it work.
Yeah, great positioning from FY, using the fog right in that, right by the top lane and waiting for the vacuum to come out. Gets the setup he needs.
FY a little bit afraid about, you know, what could potentially come as far as Sunstrikes.
This top tower is likely to go down now with the creep wave being skipped by ROTK. There's a creep wave on it as well. This is going to be a tower getting down to a couple hundred HP. FY can TP himself home, but he's just going to wait a little bit longer. But yeah, tower doesn't go down just yet. It should be an easy claim if Vici Gaming want to commit perhaps three heroes to this top lane. And FY is staying at top because he's got Drenkel Boots. He's actually going to slowly regen himself back up, so just that going for that little bit of extra efficiency and uptime.
Well, in the meantime, Freeze getting aggressive again onto this Invoker, just trying to whittle him down slowly over time so that eventually he could get another one of those Remnant plays, perhaps.
Didn't see, but perhaps just breaking that last raindrop of Miracles. I know he's been using those very effectively to stay alive in this mid lane, so sometimes just throwing away mana to break a raindrop can be value in itself. Look to be the case. Matu is invis though with an Omni Slash, now down bottom. This could be a dangerous place to be for not just Aggressive's lifesteal, but even more so the Coddle, who is tucked deep in these trees. Without a rock, he can rage. Oh, he can't rage TP away from a black hole. Kuro is here, ready to stop that TP out.
Oh, bottom lane, I think there's something that might be a brewing if we could get on down there. There it is, black hole a little bit off the mark.
A little bit.
I couldn't see a damn thing anyway. The aggressive jumps inside of a creep.
Yeah, good thing for Kuro that one maybe not fully caught.
Don't worry, nobody
saw
it.
Very far off. I think he was expecting the lifesteal to back, like his smoke pop, so the reaction is normally, oh, you smoke pop, gonna run away. No, he just kept charging forward, which was perhaps an unexpected maneuver, and that should have been the black hole Omni Slash kill. Like, yeah, you gotta commit two big ultimates for it, but it's worth it to stop Aggressive's lifestealer, and instead, he gets out, he knows there's no black hole, he's getting aggressive on this bottom lane.
Tama Man uses that over here towards the mid lane. They find the kill onto Mind Control with Freeze rotating top.
Yeah, top kill, which means it's also a top tower. Centaur dead opens up this lane, will be a free tower, and Team Liquid will continue to bleed here in this early game.
Man, this has just felt, I mean, you talked about it earlier, that it's been a little bit of a role reversal where it's actually going to be VTJ having the really good laning stage to start, and I'm wondering how this is going to translate into the mid game. Like, can they really start roaming around and just taking down these towers?
Absolutely. You've got good vehicles for the lifesteal. Even before Slaughter's Blink, you can use the Ember Spirit if you want to. Aggressive at bottom. Not going to go for the TP out. Instead, just tries to run his way out of this one. Stick plus Omni Slash coming soon.
This is a scary moment. They get the Omni Slash there. Sunstrike is going to, well, doesn't really matter. They get the kill regardless.
Yeah, a bit surprised he didn't just go for a Rage TP out there, but perhaps expecting the Omni Slash damage to kill him off. Matu's stick charges were actually on cooldown until that very last moment there. Breeze at top, looking to set up.
Well, let's see if he is going to be able to catch him. There's the Remnant forward, looking for the catch onto Mind Control. It's going to be breaking down some of these trees. He goes to the right, Freeze going to the left.
Nice juke, good use of the Quelling Blade. Chopped his way through, and Mind Control doesn't even have to TP out. He's just all the way back to safety. But, yeah, that's a nice kill in the lifesteal, slowing down the armlet timing. That would have been the go time, I think, for Aggressive. He would have been like, all right, team, I can infest into whoever, go for a kill. Darkseer's got mech. Vici Gaming very much ready to fight at this point in the game. So getting a kill on the lifesteal will help slow down some of their aggression early on. Kuro has gone for the Midas, so that's something you may look to exploit if you're VG Gaming. The fact he hasn't gone for the mech, has gone for that same build as earlier before, does limit what he can do should some constant aggression come out from VG.
And you can certainly do that with the Darkseer, who's now picked up the mechanism. You got the high mobility, as you mentioned earlier, the ability to go in with side of the Ember Spirit and the initiation. Just a ton of team fight built up already from BGJ, and aggressive, going to chase down GH right now, immediately going to go for the TP, but there's the vacuum, and that should be the kill. Was that Stampede used as well?
Yes, it was. So the Stampede being used, and will guarantee this bottom tier 1 tower. And the other great thing about Ember and Lifesteal, these are great heroes to put Iron Shell on. So we could see not just aggression around the mech, but also the Iron Shell, Ember Spirit, and Lifestealer can pose a big threat.
Oh, triple Remnant in. It doesn't end up doing damage to Matumbleman, though, and he's going to be able to back out.
Yeah, despite getting the first blood on Miracle Freeze as the one player who's kind of struggled, that top push and gank actually really helped salvage his early game because he got a kill in the center and got the T1 tower gold as well. If not for that, I feel like this Ember would be even further behind. But does manage to get some more tower gold thanks to his team. Bottom lane, aggressive, gets the tower and gets aggressive onto GH. Finds another kill.
That is just so spooky. This little guy running at you constantly and so much damage coming out. It feels like if they don't address this Lifestealer soon, which they tried to do with the Black Hole earlier, he's just going to get out of control.
Yeah, GH, I think it's a tough game for him, not because of, like, he's put on a different role. Like, this is as much as I think Kuro the Enigma, like, can suit him and all that, but Warlock doesn't really suit GH. He's a player that likes to go around being aggressive, making plays, whether it's his Slada, like, going for kills, whether it's his Rubick make doing flashy things, his Coddle, like, aggressively split pushes lanes, but you can't do that on a hero like Warlock. You're a much more defensive natured hero. He has 4 Observer Wards on him. He's not even used to buying wards. Normally that's Kuro's job, but Kuro playing the farming Enigma, so there's no vision up for Liquid. And I think we're seeing a clear kind of disconnect between GH and playing the 5 position support role. Very capable player. I'm sure he plays it plenty in like pubs here and there if he needs to, but in terms of like Liquid as a competitive team and as like a functioning unit, he hasn't really been able to hit a good level 6 timing. He hasn't been able to just play that defensive support role to great effect.
Well, they're going to need to turn this back around soon, and it feels like it has to be off the back of these big teamfight ultimates, and maybe now
Ember's ready to go. I mean, he's not going to get good rock off if he gets bound.
Oh, they find him right away at the start. Can't get anything off. He's just going to drop in mid lane again. They're going to be able to pressure this out. You got heroes rotating in, but what's Matumbleman going to do at this point? He can spin and pull the wave, maybe, but...
Yeah, he's going to try to delay it, but doesn't really offer a whole lot of fight. Needs to be careful not to get vacuumed as well. Could pull him into a tough spot if Slada's there for a crush, but good news is... Oh no, bad news is FY's got a blink. He just picked this one up. He's ready to come initiate. I don't know if Liquid are ready for this, and...
Curl does have a blink as well. He's hanging out there behind. They're ready for the counter initiation.
With a rock
play
too. This could be the team fight Liquid need.
They're smoked up. GH over there to the side. FY, he's in the trees waiting for the initiation to come.
They ideally want to burst down the Warlock without committing too many heroes. If they can kill the Warlock with like a Blink, Slaughter, and an Ember, like a 2-hero commitment, that's great. Because Enigma can't really go for a 2-man Black Hole. He needs to catch everyone with his counter-initiation.
10 heroes mid.
I like it.
A whole lot of damage going on in just a second here. We have to see where the initiation comes from.
They recognize the threats. The Warlock, the Enigma. These are the two big heroes. These are the heroes you've got to initiate on. Kill one instantly, take out one of those big ultimates. The Warlock's probably the better target, and then you don't. Then the plan is you just don't group up. Problem is, if you go on the Enigma, the Warlock Rock's going to probably hit everyone, even if you're not grouped, because of that AoE.
It's like VGJ chicken out first, at least, in that game in the mid lane that went on. Probably for the best. I think that it's hard to fight into this lineup with Fatal Bonds and everything else getting thrown out.
They dewarded, so they took away some of the Dire Vision, but then they also realized, like, okay, Warlock's positioning very defensive, and not a whole lot we can do to get on top of him. And they also hadn't seen Enigma in a while, so... Perhaps unaware of the blink, but also something they probably know the timing of. With that Midas, they're expecting it to be up at this point.
Well, 7-4, 16 minutes in. Not necessarily that frenetic pace that we saw in the last one. Looks like FY, well, he baits out the hoof stomp by mind control.
And aggressive going for his next infest into the Ember Spirit of Freeze. Perhaps the unexpected partner.
All right, FY, he's just putting on a show right now.
Here comes Ember.
might be a little bit too much for FY. Needs to be careful. They're on top of him already. This is a mind control down. Just again, VGJ continuing this dominant performance.
Aggressive is hungry again, playing this lifestealer and playing that fighting style. All he needs is the armor. He's going to get the Helm of the Dominator creep potentially as well. This is a lot of gold. Killing these is well worth it with the patch changes. Plus 125.
Ain't bad. I'm looking at this VGJ lineup. It feels like they're doing everything correct constantly all around the map. And I mean, what's this team's limit at this point? How do Liquid even respond now?
I mean, the Liquid want to go for the big team fight. So that's why they backed off that mid-tier one tower. I think VG Gaming recognized, like, we're pretty good in at team fight initially because we had this mech, we had a really strong level and farm advantage. But now that Warlock's hit level 6 and an Enigma has a blink, the team fight swings back Liquid's way. They just need these few items, and Black Hole plus Rock is going to win them fights much more so than like a vacuum into Slider Crush can. So VG Gaming's strengths with their draft is going to lie in the pickoff area. They want to keep finding these little kills, use their global mobility with the Ember Spirit Boots of Travel. They've got great mobility with the Slider Sprint and Blink. The Darkseer can blink. He's also got a very early blink. So they're using like this ganking style to try and beat the five-man of Liquid at this point.
Well, it looks like, again, Freeze in the mid lane is going to throw out one of those Remnants, wanting to stay alive.
Be careful,
they're going as well. There's going to be the Black Hole. It's down onto two. It's huge. It's going to be a kill onto two of them, and now going to be able to find a bit more. Miracle already with the double. Can they take down Aggressive? Kuro is getting turned upon, but Aggressive is kind of left on his lonesome. They have him inside of a creep wave. But man, oh man, what a distraction.
He went for the deny on it. His team were like pinging one of them, trying to figure out which one the lifesteal was in. They're auto denying these.
Now again, they're up there inside of them, and Aggressive is going to end up falling. So another great pickup. Matumbo Man takes him down, a flurry of action, and suddenly Liquid back on top.
Yeah, and they finally found a way to use some of these big teamfight winning ultimates. I mean, Kuro gets a nice black hole. Ember was so fast to react, but problem was his remnant was still inside the black hole, so he didn't actually have a good escape. But this is the downtime of the big ultimates. They're playing these long cooldown ultimates, and VG Gaming will be much stronger for the next 2 minutes. Without Black Hole, without Rock, VG Gaming can go for Roshan, they can go for this tier 1 mid. I'd expect a tier 1 mid and possibly Roshan as well to fall without Liquid able to do a whole lot in response.
Big crush. Now on to Matumbo Man, but he can just spin it out and back off there. So it did feel maybe a little bit like the Rock was slightly overkill. If they hang on to that, then maybe they were going to be able to not lose this tower here mid. I don't know. It's tough to tell.
I'm curious to see where VG go next. They know them. Oh, that Hope makes host on. That could be punished.
Yeah, they're on top of him. They drop the wall as well. A bit more damage, slowing down that mind control centaur. Maybe they farm it here for a second. I don't know.
Yeah, without Lifestealer here, they are struggling to force the issue, even with those ulties on cooldown. So back to about a minute without ulties. Tier 1, I would expect to be a freebie. Aggressive's here, and he'll race, but he won't get the last hit.
Mind control just doing it with every hero. Last time it was the Brew, this time it's the Centaur.
And here's the Roshan, as mentioned. Should be go time for VG Gaming to get as much done as possible. Anytime those ulties are used, you've got to achieve something. But with Invoker and Centaur, they can still delay this and also cause problems.
Sunstrike comes in, they realize what's happening, they're going to get that initiation off, connect onto two, there's a deafening blast, one is already gone, Aggressive is out of there, can they take down more? Chain's going to be able to contain them for the moment, but they're able to take them down. Freeze now needs to remnant out, but this, with the amp damage on top of it, might be Liquid's Roche.
They're stealing Roche without Rock, without Black Hole. Illuminate will try and deter this, but there's a healing ward, they can't get in there, and the amp actually helped out Liquid for a bit.
Oh, Malifus thought about it, but FY.
They can't stop this. Darkseer, Lifestealer, no buybacks. And it's like Lifestealer committed the rage to try and bring down Roche, not expecting Liquid to come and fight it. And they got punished because when Liquid came in and engaged, rage was on cooldown. That really backfired. And VG Gaming, I mean, the mindset is there. And I think you have to have the mindset, like, when those big ultimates are down, go and fight, go and get something done. But perhaps they should have approached it differently and use smokes there. Don't just go in blindly into Roche, knowing that your opponents can throw Sunstrike, throw Tornadoes, Meteor combos. Try and smoke up, find the kill, and turn the kill into Roshan, because your opponents are not going to want to fight into like the initiation of a Lifestealer Infest. Instead, you get no value out of Infest. No value. Rage was used on Roche, so your Lifestealer was a melee creep at that point. A melee creep that does a lot of damage, but he's also getting stunned up in control.
Well, and now looking at this as well, you do have several Midases online for Liquid. You've got one on Kuro,
wow, yeah,
the Invoker, and the Warlock. This is a lineup that, to me at least, feels like it's incredibly terrifying going into late game against.
Yeah, I mean, Miracle's Invoker is one of the scariest things in late game to verse. Lifestealer also not the dream late game carry. If you've got like a good mid-scaling carry, you can typically get away with it, as we saw last game, but I don't feel like the Ember is going to offer quite the same this game as far as a scaling late game carry, especially with his farm. He is 7k net worth. He is dirt poor. Freeze has had a rough game, and that's with the solo kill on Miracle, as mentioned, so he is not getting farm at a quick rate whatsoever. Vici Gaming find themselves in quite a big spot of trouble. We're going to see Kuro again go into that Octarine build, it looks like. He's got the soul boost. He's just incredibly tanky with a build like this, and just roaming around the enemy jungle, seeing what he can find. Reduce that cooldown on your Midas, you know.
Yeah, absolutely.
Gets the 120 GPM talent.
He is stacked up. There's no question about it. And the other thing about this, too, is you look at it, like, he is always going to be able to find that initiation pretty much because there's the threat of the rock. And it's not as if Warlock is going to be poor either. Like, if he needs to, he can go back for a Blink Dagger himself.
I mean, the ability to scale late game script, it also means they can farm incredibly fast right now. They're going to force a high ground push here. Matu, with Healing Ward, with Blade Fury, isn't too afraid of Illuminate. The whole team isn't afraid of Illuminate with the Healing Ward up, and you can't easily get to that Healing Ward. You haven't got any good heroes to bring it down.
They're on top of him, trying to get it. Vacuum Wall into the crush, but the Rock counterplay is going to be there. Everybody from Liquid is still alive for the moment, but so is VGJ. It looks like they're going to be able to call it there. A good initiation comes in for Mind Control. They're going to drop the Rock. They're going to also drop the Omni. Takes down that Lifestealer right there at the start. Matumbo Man going to be crushed for the moment. Miracle pretty low in this one. Is he going to fall? He does end up burning through the Aegis, but it is just the Aegis.
It's like they're going to disengage. Lifestealer buys back. That's already a big win in itself, and VG Gaming feel pressed to chase.
Well, they've been able to pull back one, but I don't know if it's going to be enough. And they're in the ice wall now. So frustrating. GH doesn't want to reveal himself there. It looks like they're at least going to be able to keep eyes now
RTK
onto ROTK.
Okay.
They're thinking about it. Black Hole is there. Can they hit it? Is going to be able to get the initiation from Mind Control. They're trying to set up for a big Black Hole. Kuro looking for the angle. This could be huge if he is able to find it. But
Aggressive has no rage here. He's going to be very careful. 5 seconds.
Kuro drops it. There it is, right on top of him. And this is another one.
That's a dieback.
This could end up being more.
Yeah, without an Aegis, they probably don't care as long as Lifesteal is dead. And RTK slowed down as well.
No way out of this one. They've got the Cold Snap. He's going to end up falling from bad to worse. VGJ just in a terrible position. And it looks like they're going to be able to run down the Coddle as well. And a 24-minute GG. Liquid responds strong.
That's making a statement. I mean, they win the game 24 minutes in with triple Midas. Like, they're picking up these Midases, getting some levels and all that. Normally you think, oh, triple Midas, they're looking to play late game. No, Liquid strike hard and fast with the black holes, the rocks. That Roche contest was really the big play to go back to. But like Vici Gaming just needed to go for a play with a bit more finesse. They couldn't just try and brute force the way into Roche pit, even though they had those two ultimates down. I think it was this kind of misguided sense of security because there was no black hole and no rock. Invoker, Centaur, still very disruptive, still very good at this.